Microsoft has announced a brand new family member in the Surface Pro line. It is called the Pro X. Now, there was a Pro 7 device announced this week in New York City, but the Pro X is a brand new piece of hardware from Microsoft that is running an ARM chip on the inside. The chip, known as the SQ1, was built in conjunction with Qualcomm, so it's likely a version of the 8CX or somewhere along that line that is overdrive, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But this brand new device features an all-new chassis. It has two USB Type-C ports, LTE connectivity, and is much thinner, and it is a 13-inch screen, Microsoft will say, and a 12-inch body. The screen resolution is 2880 by 1920 or 267 pixels per inch, same 3x2 aspect ratio we see on other devices, and 10-point multi-touch. It also has an Adreno 685 GPU, 8 gigs of RAM, or 16 gigs are an option, and crucially, it does have a removable, yes, that's right, a removable solid-state drive, which comes in a configuration of 128, 256, or 512. That is going to be huge in the enterprise, where companies will buy these things in bulk and need to swap out the hard drives as they do fail later on in life. It will also have a Windows Hello and a firmware TPM, Wi-Fi 5, Bluetooth, Wireless 5.0, Qualcomm Snapdragon X24 LTE modem, up to gigabit LTE advanced connectivity, and of course GPS GLONASS support and other things like that. It's also going to start at $999, and if you really want to crank the dial up, you can spend up to $1,799, and it does come in a matte black finish. Now, you are going to need a type cover with the device, and unfortunately, if you have a type cover, you're not going to be able to reuse it with this product. It has an all new configuration, and so you're a little bit out of luck on that. Now, it does not run Windows 10X. Windows 10X was also announced this week, and I will do a separate video on that, but it runs Windows 10 Home, Windows 10 Pro, and I'm sure you can run Windows 10 Enterprise on it as well. In my brief time with it, it feels great. It's nice, it's thin, it feels like a super modern version of Surface. If you like what a Surface is, you will absolutely love this. The one thing we don't know yet, and I didn't get a great chance to dive super deep into it, is the performance. Microsoft is allowing you to run any application with a couple exceptions. 32-bit applications will work just fine. 64-bit applications currently are not supported on this device, but you should be able to find just about any app that you want in 32-bit. Now, you are not going to be doing any heavy work on this. You're not going to want to be doing photo editing or video editing. That is just not what this device is designed for. It does have cameras on it, and it does have that 2880 by 1920 resolution, so it should be pretty good for productivity tasks. But at the same time, don't try to edit video. You're going to be really disappointed in a Surface Pro 7, or more candidly, a Surface Book is going to be up your alley. Now, I do like the device. It feels, like I said, it feels modern. The thinness makes the Surface Pro 7 look quite dated really quickly, which means, obviously, that device is going to get revised next year, and I continue to hear that the codename of that project is Carmel, so look for that next year. But for this year, it's the Surface Pro X. That is what Microsoft is pushing, and I'm intrigued. You can see that it feels sturdy, it feels confident, and has the same style of keyboard that we see on every other Surface device, and it looks good too. Microsoft has done a good job with this, but again, it's going to come down to the performance of the SQ1 chip, which is more than likely an overdrive version of an 8CX. It is running at 3 gigahertz on the cores, and the one downside to this device is that it only gets 13 hours of battery life. Yeah, that's right, 13 hours. Many other ARM devices get 18 to 20, and so that is a big kind of shot across the bowel of the device because, while ARM does have a lot of advantages, the primary reason you buy it is longevity and ease of use. And without that longevity, it's not great. Now, Microsoft is saying that it will quick charge up to 80% of a recharge in an hour, which is honestly fantastic, but you will get that on other Surface devices. So why would you buy this device? Well, one, it looks great. Two, it does have LTE connectivity out of the box. People who like that stuff are going to really enjoy this. If you're looking for a first-line, front-line, mobile-only device where your priorities are mobility and connectivity, the Pro X, I think, fits the bill for that. And it will be available here in early November. And this has just been a first quick look, and I'll have a much more deeper dive once I get my review unit. Until then, we'll catch all of you right back here next time.